Rajan Gupta, Chairman and Non-Executive Director. Mr. Piyush Pankaj, Business Head, CATV and Chief Strategy Officer. And Mr. Anil Bothra, Chief Financial Officer. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in the listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star then zero on the touchtone phone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Nawal Seth of Emkay Global. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. I would like to welcome the management and thank them for this opportunity. I shall now hand over the call to the management for their opening remarks. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Nawal. Good evening, everyone. A warm welcome to all of you to the conference call of GTPL Hathway Limited to discuss financial and operational performance of Quarter 1, 2022. GTPL Hathway continued to deliver on key KPIs during Quarter 1, 2022. The highlights of the quarter was robust subscriber addition and subscription revenue for broadband business, strong profitability and debt repayment. GTPL has further reduced its debt by 168 million in Quarter 1, 2022. GTPL will continue to march forward on its stated strategic roadmap by coming up with interesting and new products and services, enhancing customer experience, strengthening its digital infrastructure and capability, and escalating its footprint in the existing and new market. With that, I hand over to Mr. Piyush Pankaj, who can take you through the business and financial aspect of the company.
Thank you, Mr. Jadeja. Good evening, everyone. I hope all of you are safe and healthy. GTPL Hathway is one of the few consistently profit-making cable TV and broadband company in India. Our business model is quite robust and can explore multiple growth opportunities that this sector has the potential to offer. In the last 5 years, our CATV subscriber base has grown sharply by 2x to 7.3 million. Additionally, our broadband subscriber base has mirrored and a significant growth of 3.6x to reach 0.7 million. We have been consistently generating healthy free cash flow and have managed to reduce our gross debt by 420 crore in the last 5 years and have returned the money to shareholders in the form of regular dividends. I'm happy to share with you that GTPL Limited has been recognized as one of India's top 500 companies by Dun & Bradstreet, ranked 401 on turnover in the listing published for 2021. Additionally, during Quarter 1 FY22, we have launched GTPL Interactive Virtual Assistant, Jiva, a WhatsApp-based chatbot for 24/7 customer support for CATV and broadband businesses. Let me now share the performance highlights for the quarter. As on June 30, 2021, our active TV subscribers stood at 8 million. GTPL's digital CATV services now reaches 1,000 plus towns spread across 15 states in India. The company is expanding aggressively in Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu, and the north states. GTPL CATV platform services own and operate 48 channels across over 6 genres. The CATV industry offers an underlying growth opportunity for an organized and seasoned player like GTPL Hathway. Our CATV business expansion will gain momentum with organic and inorganic growth in the coming quarters. The Indian wireline broadband sector is a sunrise industry with huge untapped growth potential. It accounts for meager 6% penetration of the total households in India, as against 80% in Japan, 70% in Eurozone, and 55% in China. This represents a huge opportunity for growth for us. In the broadband segment, we added 2,30,000 new home pass in Quarter 1 FY22, and taking their total home pass as on June 30, 2021 to 4.10 million. During the quarter, GTPL added 55,000 net broadband subscribers, taking the total net broadband subscribers as on June 30, 2022 to 6,90,000. The broadband ARPU for quarter 1 FY22 grew by 4% YOY to Rs. 440 per month. GTPL looks forward to expanding its broadband business by leveraging its existing base of 10 plus million CATV subscribers and attracting new broadband subscribers through business partners. Let me now move to our financial performance. On our consolidated business, excluding EPC contract, during quarter 1 FY22, GTPL's consolidated revenue grew by 22% YOY to 5843 million. The CATV subscription revenue stood at Rs. 2641 million. The broadband revenue for the quarter grew by 74% YOY to Rs. 918 million, led by healthy subscribers additions. EBITDA for the quarter increased by 8% YOY to Rs. 1362 million with a margin of 23.3%. On our consolidated business, including EPC contract, during quarter 1 FY22, GTPL's consolidated revenue grew by 22% to Rs. 6106 million. EBITDA for the quarter increased by 7% YOY to Rs. 1380 million with a margin of 22.6%. PAT for the quarter surged by 16% YOY at Rs. 475 million. The finance cost during the quarter was lower by 78% YOY and 62% QOQ. Our EPC contract during quarter 1 FY22 reported the revenue, EBITDA and profit before tax of Rs. 263 million, Rs. 18 million and Rs. 18 million respectively. On our standalone business, excluding EPC contract, during quarter 1 FY22, the company's revenue grew by 14% YOY to Rs. 3740 million. The company reported EBITDA of Rs. 778 million with an EBITDA margin of 20.8%. On our standalone business, including EPC contracts, during quarter 1 FY22, the company's revenue surged by 14% YOY to Rs. 4003 million. EBITDA stood at Rs. 796 million with an EBITDA margin of 19.9%. PAT during the quarter stood at Rs. 305 million. This is all from my side. Thank you everyone for your attention. We can now begin with the questions and answer sessions.
Thank you very much. We will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on the touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. The first question is from the line of Pratiksha Daftari from Equitas. Please go ahead.
Thank you for the opportunity, sir. Okay, my first question is if you could tell us for cable TV, what was the ARPU in this quarter? And if you could explain, the subscriber decline that we had and how do we see things currently?
Hi, Pratiksha.
Hi.
This quarter, the ARPU remains same. If you do the calculation, you will get it at 122 rupees, 122 point something. So the ARPU is flat this quarter. This quarter, we have witnessed as the year opens and the COVID has gone into its highest numbers. in April and May, and it was a difficult time for everyone, for every business. We faced that in cable also. We tried to maintain our subscriber bases. The main hit has come from the corporate subscribers, which was, we were seeing that in the last quarter of last year, the corporate subscribers started coming back to our fold. And in April and May, we have seen that they have gone away again. And in June, some of them have returned back. We are hopeful that as the situation will improve, we will get back our corporate subscriber base, and again, we will bounce back. So that's why you have seen that there is 200K subscriber base down. Some effect has come because of cyclone, which is Tauktae cyclone, which has hit the Gujarat and Maharashtra. And there is a Yash cyclone, which has hit in the West Bengal market. Still, some of the subscriber base, which we have, which is still to come from because of these cyclones. So we are expecting that in the quarter two, as the situation will improve, we will get back these subscribers who is still not back after the cyclone, and plus the corporate subscribers.
Okay. So did we have any, on non-corporate side, retail side, did we have any gross additions for this quarter?
Yeah, if I talk about, we lost around 350K, 375K in the corporate side. The retail side has gone up by around 150 to 175K between that, and the net figure is 200K.
Okay, understood. Okay, and this time we've seen pay channel cost as a percentage to our cable TV revenues have gone up substantially. So is there any change in our commercial arrangement with the broadcasters, or by?
Prateeksha, you have to see the channel cost in conjunction with our placement and marketing revenues. If you see the increase in placement and marketing and increase in the pay channel cost is similar, there is no impact on the gross margin due to the pay channel.
Okay. Understood. On the broadband front, we've seen some decent growth on home pass additions this time. So, do we expect the trajectory to continue?
Yeah, we are trying to continue this trajectory. This quarter was difficult for us on the ground, but still we managed to do that 230K home passes. We are going to continue that.
And on the subscriber addition front, do we see the growth rate increasing, or how do we look at subscriber addition in broadband for this year, the remaining?
As in the last call also, we have given that we were going to add between 50 to 60K every quarter. This quarter, we added 55K. So we are hopeful that the projections on which we have working or we have given, we are going to continue on that basis.
Okay. Understood. And any update on the litigation front?
Which litigation you're talking about?
DOT.
Oh, okay. No, there is no update on the AGR side. Court was not into the order. So no hearing has happened on those. So no.
So when is our hearing scheduled, sir, right now?
Rajan sir, do you have the update on this?
No, Piyush, no update as of now. I think you can offline update them, as and when the developments happen.
Yeah.
Okay. And sir, on the EPC, I think, can we assume that now all the revenue recognition for the EPC contract, excluding obviously the O&M, is revenue recognition and expenses is done with?
Almost 98% is done.
Okay. All right. Now, sir, a couple of data points. If you could share receivable position as on June and the capex plan for the remaining of the year.
Receivables position is 352 crores
If you see quarter four, we were at around 383 crores. The receivable has come down by 30 crores. It is at 352 crores around on this quarter. And on capex, this quarter we did 82 crores of capex, which 49 crore of capex is in the broadband and 33 crore of capex is in the CATV.
Okay. Sir, how much of the receivables would be from broadcasters? How much would be for EPC?
Broadcaster is around 165 crore and EPC is around 120 crores.
And are we facing any issues in receivables from the for the EPC contract?
No, we have not facing any issues. If you see, last quarter we have given that we have 226 crore of EPC project receivables. Now it has gone, it has reduced to 120 crore.
Okay. And sir, CAPEX guidance remains the same for the full year?
CAPEX, the projections which we have given that we are going to do between 350 to 400 crores, that is going to be remain same right now.
Okay. All right, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Dixit Doshi from Whitestone Financial Advisors. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thanks for the opportunity. Some of my questions have been answered. Just a couple of things. Firstly, if I see the cable TV segment-wise result on a consolidated basis, you know, year on year the revenue has gone up, even quarter on quarter it has gone up. But cable TV PBT has not gone up in that proportion. In fact, quarter on quarter, it has come down by almost 5-10%. So, what led to that? Is there any one-off or any cost increase?
PBT, if you talk about at that time, you can see that depreciation is going up as you are doing more and more investment. And one of the reason is whatever increase we are taking in our revenues and all, that is coming down with the depreciation. So one factor is the depreciation, as you see. PBT has increased. If I compare it with the last year, quarter one, FY21, if you talk about, that is from 575 crore, that has gone to 75 crore. I'll just give you the figure of the PBT. On the consolidated basis, if you see, the quarter one FY21 ex-EPC, the PBT was at 56 crore. And if you compare it with the quarter one FY22 ex-EPC,
no,
PBT has 732 crores.
Yeah, but predominantly this increase was due to the broadband business. I'm talking just about the cable TV business. So if I see, there was almost 15-17% jump in the cable TV revenue year on year. But PBT in cable TV business has gone up hardly anything, like couple of crores. And in fact, quarter on quarter, it has come down, cable TV PBT.
You have to see in a different way, because the subscription of CATV is flat from last year. It was at 183 crore last year. This quarter also it was on 183 crore. But still, your PBT has increased by around 6 crore, from 35 crores to 42 crores in the from the quarter to YOY basis. So the contribution on the PBT is happening. But yeah, the revenue side you talk about, it has gone from 327 to 374. But cost side also has gone up from 248 to 396. You have to see the business in the basis of clubbing, placement and pay channel together and see the net margin increase on that. So pure on subscription, it is flat from last year. But on PBT, we are getting around 6 crore of PBT. So PBT is increasing, still the revenue is same.
Okay. In terms of cable TV subscribers, so this year obviously due to the pandemic in Q1, it has come down. But
over, let's say, next couple of years or 3 years, what kind of gross, what kind of net cable TV subscriber addition we can expect annualized?
So we are planning, our planning is obviously coming 3 years, almost close to around 3 million. Each year we wanted to plan to roll out 1 million. But yes, because of this pandemic, it's huge. But our projection is year on year, it's a 1 million every year.
Okay. Okay. And last question from my side is, was there, how much we did spend on this, you know, appointing Boman Irani and the, this new, you know, campaign launch, how much we would have extra spend during this quarter?
It's hardly, it's 0.5% of the revenue which has gone into that.
Okay. Okay. And any update on hybrid box launch?
Yeah. Hybrid box, we are launching somewhere in August right now. Hybrid box is already with us. It has got delayed because of the pandemic and because the shipment has got delayed. We got the shipment in mid of July now, and we are planning to launch in August. Everything is completed. The testing is going on.
Okay. Okay. That's it from my side. Thanks.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Saptashree Chatterjee from Centrum PMS. Please go ahead.
Yeah, sir. Thank you for the opportunity and congratulations on a good quarter amidst the pandemic second wave. So my question is on the broadband side. Most of the questions have been answered. On the broadband side, the ARPU has been 440 rupees, slightly around 5 rupees lower than last quarter. Whereas, like, the, we have expected trend to be higher because of people are upgrading the plans. So if you can give some color on that front.
Rajan sir?
No, broadband, I think, as far as ARPUs are concerned, I mean, they have been pretty stable. And I think more than ARPU, you know, we have been anyway indicating that, you know, there is no plan to ARPU increase. So ARPUs will remain, broadly speaking, stable. And quarter to quarter, they'll keep on increasing 5 rupees or decreasing 5 rupees based on the pack mix change. But I think a bigger picture, which we have to see on broadband is, UTPL is in a very sweet spot, which we have been updating you for last many quarters, okay? In a state where only BSNL is a major competition and nobody has this kind of network, the amount of investment we have done in network in terms of upgradation from ME into GPON and the kind of service improvement which we could exhibit both in terms of speed quality and overall network quality, okay, we are kind of in a sweet spot. That's where you are seeing this kind of results in a quarter and quarter in terms of increase in revenue, subscriber numbers, you know, EBITDAs. And you know, without any disruption because of any other competition, actually, you know, A, because ARPUs are low, and B, EBITDA levels are very healthy. You know, you would have seen the EBITDA levels, upwards of 40% EBITDA with this kind of ARPU. So essentially, that means that DTPL can keep on expanding more and more in within Gujarat itself. Okay, and it's a very large state at a very affordable price point of 400 to 500 and keep on growing for many, many quarters to come. So I think that's a better way to look at it. Quarter and quarter, yes, there will be 5 rupees variation here and there in the ARPU. But there is no change in plans or there is no drop in pricing which has happened.
Sure, sir. And in the cable TV, like we have said that we are expecting around 1 million subscriber increase every year. So that will basically, are we talking about expanding in market share out of these 170 million paying subscribers, right? So from whom we are expecting to gain market shares and majorly in which states, if we can classify?
We are expanding very fast in Maharashtra, Andhra, Telangana, Tamil Nadu, and Northeast. Plus, we will add more states going forward.
And this will come from majorly our which competitors, maybe in the like DTH or mostly our MSOs only?
It is going to be mix of that. We have, as in earlier calls, we have said that we have started the programs, and through marketing, through direct selling, everything to tap the DTH market and bring back them to the table. That is already going on in the strategy. Plus, there is going to be the strategy of consolidating the market going forward with the cable TV.
Sure, sir. Very helpful. And is it possible to give any color on the hybrid plans, like what kind of ARPUs, margins, anything on that front? Anything?
We are going to launch very soon. It is hardly now 15 to 20 days, 2 to 3 weeks. I think it will be colored everywhere. So I will say that wait for 2 to 3 weeks more.
Sure, sir. Thank you. I'll come back in the queue.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Kush Kanjal from Care PMS. Please go ahead.
Hi. So most of my questions have been answered. Just last. So with the current AGR case going on, recent, I think yesterday there was some hearing regarding some mathematical errors. Does that impact us? If you can just highlight on that.
No, that is for telecom, not for this.
Okay. It will not impact us.
Okay. Sure. Okay. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Nikhil Jain from Jayalakshmi International. Please go ahead.
Yeah, sure. Thank you. Thanks for the opportunity. Just one question, actually. So fundamentally, our revenues from, if you look at YOY basis, our revenues are increased by more than 20%. However, our PBT has increased by only 7%. So what would be the major reason for that? So that was one. And second, is there any kind of indication or guidance from the management for the rest of the year? Let's say what kind of EBITDA margins we can manage. So whatever we are having now, would this be sustained, or there can be a potential increase in the change given the benefit of operating leverage? These are my questions. Thank you.
You're right that our total income has increased by 22% YOY, but the expenditure has increased by 28% YOY also. And thus, EBITDA has just increased by 8% YOY from 126 crore. It has gone up to 136 crore. And that's why you are seeing that in the PBT, it has increased by around 30% from 56 crore to 73 crore YOY. So these are the figures, and it's a consistent one, as you see that EBITDA growth, which is happening YOY, is between 8 to 10%. And as we are reducing our finance costs substantially, we are getting the gain in the PBT. So that is reflecting here that PBT has gone up by 30% YOY on this.
Right, sir. But the point was that, the finance cost is a limit, right? So we are already down to a good, so we have reduced the debt significantly. So we can obviously looking to reduce it further, and it will go down further. But the point was that if the EBITDA growth is going to be 8 to 10% in the business, which can be potentially, let's say, having good operating leverage. So I just wanted to understand, is there any specific reason? So what are the activities that we are doing which are reducing our EBITDA growth as compared to the top line growth? So that's what. Because finance costs will have a... Yeah,
that's right. So I will not go to PBT level then. I will say that we are in the expanding mode, as you know, in the broadband business also and in the cable business also. When you are expanding, then you have to do some extra expenses, which you have to take out, establish the market. You have to enter into the new market, establish the whole thing. So your cost increases at that point of time for a you can say till the substantial number you gain, so that your per sub cost goes down on those markets. So that is where we have to go, and we are going aggressive in our new markets and bringing down, because there is a fixed cost. As the number of subscribers will grow, you will get the more contribution towards your EBITDA. So that's what's the way we have to go, and we are doing on that way. As far as concern about the EBITDA margin, we are at around 23% EBITDA margin, and this will be maintained.
Okay. Sorry. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Neil Savla from RV Equities. Please go ahead.
Hello. Can you hear me?
Yeah, please. Can you hear that?
I can hear you, yeah. So the question was basically that given that we are generating very good cash flow and we are now net cash, are you looking actively at any acquisitions, especially on the cable side of the business, since you said you are looking at, you know, consolidation in that market?
Yes, we are working on organic way or inorganic way. We'll see.
So we have a strategy to increase our sub base inorganically and organically. So yes, we are working on the acquisitions also.
Hello?
Yeah, I'm done. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Dixit Doshi from Whitestone Financial Advisors. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thanks for the opportunity again. Just one question. You know, one of our the competitor, Next Digital, they have this HITS model, head end to satellite model, and recently, you know, they have got the approval from the ministry that they can give the services to others as well. And they were mentioning that, you know, it reduces the connectivity cost of the MSO where there is a density of the population is very low. So they are targeting, you know, in the interior. So how does this can impact, you know, our business? We are also, you know, trying to expand through by acquiring the more and more MSOs.
So basically, we are not in HITS model, but yes, as you said, expansion mein, aaj ki tarikh mein going forward, the fiber and lease cost and bandwidth cost bhi itna sasta hone ja raha hai ki aapko HITS cost se bhi wo better down the line lease cost gir rahi hai. Isliye we are not going ahead with this HITS. But yes, now everywhere, even though under this Digital India BharatNet projects and all, everywhere fiber availability is there, all lease circuits are there. So everywhere is now, rural part is also, we covered everywhere.
Rajan sir?
Yeah, Adobhai, I just want to add to it. So ladies and gentlemen, first let's understand HITS is not a new technology. It is not as if first year HITS has come. It has been existing for many years, and in spite of that, DTPL is the only MSO with a double its space, okay, as far as cable TV is concerned. Okay. Second, as a part of our business vision, obviously we have this whole convergence as a part of the plan. Okay. And with the kind of fiber we have in Gujarat and in many other states, specifically in Gujarat, obviously it makes sense to keep on expanding broadband home passes and make sure consumer get both the services. Okay. And because obviously future is convergence. So while we keep on evaluating every technology, and there is no permanent no to any technology, okay, but as of now, we are fairly confident. We'll keep on repeating the past market share gains, and then focus will be more on convergence and keep on taking broadband to more and more, kind of homes in Gujarat and other states as well.
And yes, HITS is a one-way technology.
Okay. That's it from me.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, to ask a question, you may please press star and one. The next question is from the line of Tarun Kumar from OSPL. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi. Can you hear me?
Yes, Tarun.
I actually wanted to ask about the satellite broadband that is coming in as a new technology. Recently, there have been some articles about the same, and maybe Airtel is trying to do something in this space. So, just wanted to have your understanding about this technology and you know, the potential that it has, and maybe if we can tap into it.
Rajan sir,
so again, you know, satellite broadband, you know, whatever information we have currently available in public domain or otherwise, okay, it's for a very niche kind of area. It's for areas where the regular fiber broadband is not easily reachable, okay, and because the kind of economics today fiber broadband has, as I keep on repeating, GTPL is able to give in a sub 500 rupees pricing per month. Okay, without any investment from consumer. Consumer has to literally invest 0 rupee and consumer can pay 500 rupee and get a 100 Mbps, you know, unlimited broadband. Okay. As per our evaluation, no technology currently meets that kind of, you know, it's not possible through any other technology. So satellite broadband is a niche. Okay. The kind of pilots also which have happened across the world, they're happening more for niche areas, areas where fiber connectivity is not easily reachable. And giving consumers access to high-speed broadband in those areas, and we are quite certain that the kind of value for money, you know, this whole fiber broadband or FTTH technology offers, that's not replicable currently by any technology.
Okay, so basically, right now you're saying that what we have, like the fiber broadband, on a cost basis, is continuing to be superior than even the satellite broadband that is. That they might be able to launch at the price difference, right?
And both, you know, it's not only, one is the recurring charges per month, second is the device charges. If you study, okay. Like, I don't want to waste time of everybody on this call. That's a separate topic, actually. You know, we can spend a couple of hours understanding that. The kind of consumer premises equipment satellite broadband needs. Okay? So it's a lot of equipment, just like the HITS technology earlier they mentioned. Okay, and here we are giving every day thousands of connections without any installation charges or deposit, anything from consumer. You know, consumer can pay and get 500 rupees, 100 Mbps. That's simply not possible. There you have to put a lot of equipment at the consumer place and there are a lot of one-time charges, etc. So basically the technology is not meant for mass markets like, you know, like India or whatever. Yeah, there will be a lot of use cases which will come, and but that will be for very niche areas. Our focus in GTPL is obviously in the mass market.
Correct. So whatever markets we are targeting, it's going to be unlikely that satellite broadband competes with us, right?
Absolutely.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Nikhil Jain from Jayalakshmi International. Please go ahead.
Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity again. A couple of questions. So one was, let's say the the organization is owned 37% by Hathaway, which in turn is owned by Reliance, right? So is there any kind of, let's say, arrangement that we have, let's say, any kind of potential mutual collaboration that is there between us and Reliance, or we operate as completely different entities altogether and compete in the same markets, and is there any benefit that is coming in from the shareholding or there is none? So that was question one.
Yeah, so GTPL right now is going ahead on their own strategy and own brand. And we are privileged that Jio is our partner, Hathaway is our partner throughout. And the benefits you can talk about, the best part is all the benefits GTPL is getting. Whether it is vendor negotiations, whether it is
content
launch strategy, whether it is content side, whether it is knowledge sharing and all. But yes, GTPL is working as independent on their own brand and own strategy. And there is understanding on the ground that we are, as a group company, we are going to complement each other in the market, and we maintain that.
Okay. So does that mean that, is there some kind of an arrangement on the ground that, okay, we will not be competing, or we will be competing as aggressively as we compete, let's say, with Airtel or let's TV subscribers and other people?
No, we are competing in the market, but we are not disturbing each other. If we have to do some work in the ground, we will do in the joint strategy against the third player, and we will help each other to grow. So that is the understanding, and that is the market understanding on which we are working.
Okay, thank you. So that was the first question. The second, I just wanted to understand if it can be sent offline also, that is fine. What are the broadband customers and cable TV customers that we have on a state-wise basis? Because I was just looking at it, and we are now present both cable TV and broadband in let's say around 8 states, and then another 5 or 6 states where we are present either through broadband or through cable TV, which let's say is we are covering, let's say, the most popular 13-14 states of the country, right? So I just wanted to understand that has management thought that what is the strategy of expansion for the management? So do we want to go into more number of states, or do we want to consolidate our presence? Do we want to be as strong, number one, number two, in many other states, or do we want to open more states, let's say? So some strategy, some thoughts.
One of the strategy of choosing the going into the market, GDPL always believe that whether it is cable or whether it is broadband, it's a density market, the way of density market business. So whichever city or whichever area you go, you have to be the dense subscriber base on those areas. See, in the cable, you can go on the strategy basis of the whole state. You can go on the strategy basis on 5 cities, or you can go on the strategy of having 10 districts. But whichever way you go, you should have the density, and you should be number one, number two player in those areas, in those districts, in those state, on those levels. So state comes in the last. You have to understand that when you are entering into a new state, first you have to go for 2-3 districts, and you will make yourself number one on those districts first. And then you expand in other districts, and slowly you become number one, number two in the whole state. Because cable or broadband is a local business, you can say. It's not like global that you have created one infrastructure and it is whole for the state. No, you have to incrementally create your infrastructures and go for the business. But yeah, this is sure that wherever GTPL is going, we go in the way that we should be number one, number two in the short period, and we start making money on those markets.
Right. So that's the right thing, actually. So that is what I also believe, because somewhere when I look at the number of states, and these are very popular and very big states, I get a feeling that, okay, are we spreading ourselves too thin? But thank you for the clarification. So can I assume then that when we are going in Andhra, or we are going in Telangana, or in Maharashtra, or any new state, we are focusing on a district by district and trying to make money and trying to consolidate ourselves in that before expanding to the entire state, right?
Yeah, that's right. That's why I'm giving that every time the statement that we are expanding very aggressively in Maharashtra, Telangana, Andhra, Tamil Nadu, Northeast, because we have still to cover a lot of districts on those states. So that's why we are expanding aggressively on those markets. If you talk about Gujarat, we are already in all the districts in Gujarat, already present, except one or two, which we are going to expand small here. But if you talk about Maharashtra, Telangana, Andhra, Tamil Nadu, Northeast, still a lot of districts are there where we can expand, and that's why the statement is that we are aggressively expanding in these markets.
Right. Right. Thank you. So just one last, and maybe just pardon me if it is not so correct. But the point is that should we not actually go one state by one state? Should we actually go consecutively or together in 5 states or 6 states, or maybe a little more actually, right?
Strategic question. I think we should take it one to one. It depends that what company is taking this strategy and how. So this is a strategic question.
Right, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Participants, you may press star and one to ask a question. The next question is from the line of Radhima Chandak from Roha Asset Managers. Please go ahead.
Thank you for the opportunity, sir. So my question is on the CATV side. So basically, in this quarter, what leads to the reduction in the CATV EBIT margins on a QOQ and a YOY basis both, even after increasing this revenue?
Yeah, so if you talk about just the CATV, we are down by around 1 crore at the EBITDA level from the YOY basis, and that is mainly because the subscription CATV is a bit down, and the second is your activation revenue. The deferred revenue of activation is reducing, and that's why if you see there are a 6 crore of impact on the activation revenue. But in EBITDA, the impact is just 1 crore.
Okay. Is there any pressure on the pricing also? Nothing like that?
No pressure on the pricing. As I stated that the ARPU is maintained, and whenever we get the situation improves in the market, then we are going to increase the ARPU.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Participants, please press star and one to ask a question now. Ladies and gentlemen, you may press star and one. The next question is from the line of Nitesh Lania from Fractal Capital. Please go ahead.
Good afternoon, sir. Miten here. Just wanted to understand, in terms of the incremental home pass that we are doing now, where is the proportion of overlap on our cable business? So I think you answered this last time, but are we deviating on that at all or no?
No, we are not deviating. Our stand is, as Miten, it is clear from the beginning that for doing the better ROI, we are riding on our cable businesses for giving it to the broadband services, and we are expanding wherever our broadband business, our cable business is there, that to be in the broadband also.
And you don't see that changing for the next 3 years at least? You'll keep on doing an overlap with your cable business?
Yes, we are going to do those overlap. We are going to come with the broadband through partners. That strategy is already there, already pilot is over, and we are going to launch that, but we are going to do through partners on our network only, on our cable network only.
So effectively no greenfield area for broadband is being targeted?
Greenfield area is together we are targeting for the cable and broadband. If like new building is coming, new areas are getting developed.
But it's the same state or same district or same town. Yeah.
Okay. So you may be in the process also expanding your geographical territory of your cable business. That's what you're trying to say.
That's right. That's already we are doing. We are doing it in our current states also and our new states also.
Fair. And if one were to understand the incremental profitability of broadband, by looking at the numbers we can get a fair sense, but if we were to just simply look at incremental EBITDA margins for a new subscriber added on the existing home pass, that would be at what number, sir?
If you talk about EBITDA, because it's not capex is different. On EBITDA, if you see, so it's around 42%, which is we are getting straightway incremental in our EBITDA.
That would be on the whole base per se, right? But on an incremental basis, it will be higher than 40.
Yeah, on incremental basis, if you talk about that, I am adding subscriber base where already I have subscriber base, then when you're talking about we have created the
Piyush, in existing markets, essentially gross margin. So gentlemen, you know, if your question is, in existing home passes, where already, for example, 15% penetration is there, and if we add another 3% penetration, how much will be the addition to the margin? You know, because fixed cost is already there in those markets. So it will be basically gross margin is what will go to the kind of, you know, profit line. Obviously, below EBITDA, whatever lines are there, depreciation, etc., that will come. But gross margin is what will get added to EBITDA. And gross margin is typically, in most of the markets, more than 70%. I mean, that's finally, above gross margin, your cost of only, you know, bandwidth and money which we pay to channel partners, you know, in terms of the distributor commission or partner commission.
So 70 is the number. Got it. Understood.
Yeah, I mean.
Thank you. That answers it. Thank you.
Thanks, Mithil.
Thank you. Before we move to the next question, a reminder to the participants, anyone who wishes to ask a question, please press star and one now. The next question is from the line of Dhruv Shah from Ambika Financial. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi team. good evening. So I just have one, I have a couple of questions linked to the one thing. How many of our 4.1 home passes would be coming from Gujarat?
Home pass is around 90%, 92% is from the Gujarat.
Okay, understood. The reason why I'm asking that question, sir, is because apart from Gujarat, your plans for broadband doesn't seem to be anywhere competing other likes, right? Because if you see your likes, your offering in Hyderabad, you are charging 100 Mbps for almost close to 850 rupees, whereas Jio is charging only 699. So apart from Gujarat, why is our offering really not competitive?
So basically, majorly our focus on B2C is only on Gujarat. Other states, our plan to go ahead with our business partners, like our joint venture partners or our LCO partners and all.
Hyderabad market, it's a B2B. Yeah, it's a B2C subscribers are less over there. So still, we are working with our business partners. And surely, we will replicate what we are doing it in Gujarat. So that will happen.
Even if you work with your business partners, but we don't have any say in the kind of offering we have, because if you see in Nagpur, our maximum offering is 50 Mbps, and that too, it's a 15-month period and 480 rupees per month.
Piyush, I will take this question. Yeah. So gentlemen, some of our colleagues here in the stall itself spoke about focus, right?
Right.
So if you see last 12 quarters, what we have been talking about here in this call, that we are limited capital, we like to use that capital in areas where we getting maximum ROI. Okay. So around 12 quarters back, we identified Gujarat as the market where we have dominant leadership in cable, where we have excellent trade relationship, where we saw a sweet spot that apart from BSN, no other large telco is able to do any substantial wireless broadband business. Okay. And we all agreed that right from during IPO time, that this business makes only money if you are number one or number two and below a particular volume threshold in a particular market. Okay. Which is where we said Gujarat has a huge amount of home pass available. Okay. And the way our unit economics work, even at an average R2 of 450, we make greater than 40% EBITDA. Okay. Which is where, and you know, to offer 100 Mbps, you have to first upgrade the network from MEN to GPON FTTH. And every quarter, like some of us spoke about additional depreciation, etc., because every quarter we have been spending money on upgrading network as well as creating new home passes in Gujarat market. We haven't even exhausted that. Okay. So you're right, you know, one can go to Nagpur, one can go to Hyderabad. Hyderabad already has three players with a very developed market where no net adds at market level are getting added. Hyderabad already has more than 11 lakh, 12 lakh wireline broadband consumers who are getting at a very affordable price, 100 Mbps speed. Okay. Now, identifying through our channel partners some gaps For example, say outskirts Hyderabad or in Warangal, where quality broadband service is not available, and over a period we can develop that franchise as Piyush is rightly mentioning. But frankly, our prime focus will be on markets where we can be number one player, okay, and where we are the first entrant. And that's where you can make, even at a 450 price point, you know, greater than 40% EBITDA. So while some work here or there will keep on happening, but I think as a strategy itself, the focus is on Gujarat, at least for next few quarters, where there is still a lot of meat is there. So we can go anywhere, but it's more like management decided to kind of focus on areas where first we can be market leader, we can be the one who creates the market, and then we can kind of, you know, be a dominant leader there.
Right. So apart from Gujarat, so if you can just if I can just elaborate on that, which is the other state which you're looking to expand apart from Gujarat?
Right now, major focus is in Gujarat. We are present in Patna, Varanasi, Jaipur, Nagpur, Pune, and Hyderabad. But these are the small operations. We are going to concentrate on these markets and develop this market as the capex and all those things permits us. But yeah, these are the six focus market right now where we have entered, and we are going to go aggressively on that with the time.
Okay, and so my next question is there any inorganic opportunity in the broadband space? You have alluded to the fact that you are looking for inorganic opportunity in cable TV, but are there any opportunity on the broadband space also which you will be looking at?
कोई उतना बड़े लेवल पे तो कोई है नहीं, जो भी है छोटे छोटे आईएसपी, आई थिंक इट्स 5,000-10,000, थोड़ा बहुत गुजरात या थोड़ा बहुत में है, बाकी उतना कुछ खास बड़ा अपॉर्चुनिटी नहीं आ रहा।
ओके ओके सर, थैंक यू सो मच।
थैंक यू पार्टिसिपेंट्स, यू मे प्रेस स्टार एंड वन टू आस्क अ क्वेश्चन नाउ। As there are no further questions, I would now like to hand the conference over to the management for closing comments.
Thanks everyone for joining the earning call of FY22 quarter one of GTPL Hathway Limited. Be safe and healthy. We will meet again on the next quarter earnings call. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. On behalf of MK Global Financial Services Limited, that concludes this conference. Thank you for joining us, and you may now disconnect your lines.